Lindsay Dudfield this morning from Jindalee Resources. Lindsay, good morning.
Yes, good morning, Andrew. How are you?
Very well, thank you, Lindsay. Big morning for Jindalee and McDermitt. You've fired the starting gun on the PFS and appointed a lead engineer. Tell us a bit more.
Yes, no, we're very happy to announce that we have commenced the PFS and that Fluor, the very large and highly experienced US engineering company, have been appointed as lead engineer for the PFS. As your investors would probably be aware, we put a scoping study out in, or we completed one in September 2021, and because it was heavily reliant on inferred resources at the time, the production and financial metrics for McDermitt, couldn't be announced. We've since gone back and we've done a lot of infill drilling, and we've grown the resource significantly to the point where it's now the largest lithium deposit in the United States, and of global significance. And more importantly, we've increased the proportion of indicated from 20% to just over 60%, or sorry, just over 50%. And it's grown from 1.8 million tonnes of lithium carbonate equivalent to 11.1. So just over six times the size it was back in September 2021. And that's very important because that then feeds into the PFS, that indicated resource becomes probable reserve, and that will enable us to announce production metrics and also financial metrics for the project, which is something we weren't able to do in the scoping study because of the reliance on inferred resource. So look, I'm very excited that we're finally underway and really looking forward to the results of this PFS so we can finally get those production and financial metrics into the market.
And you're targeting the December quarter for the completion of the PFS.
Yes, that's right. So we've already kind of informally started the PFS in the background. We've been working on the geology. We're selecting samples for detailed metallurgical test work, which will help optimize the flow sheet for the PFS. Obviously the resource update, which we announced late February. That was a very important milestone and it gave us the confidence to proceed straight to a PFS. So it's very nice. And Fluor have also been managing our metallurgical test work for us. They completed a review end of March. So they're very familiar with this project and they're very excited about the results we've been able to achieve from the project to date and looking to, hopefully improve on those further. So.
And have you got plans for some additional drilling at McDermitt?
Yes, we're currently working under the lowest level of approval on BLM lands, which is a notice level. And we've been able to, through rehabilitating some of the drilling that we did last year, we've been able to, if you like, get some credit, which we can then use for doing some further drilling this year. But we're targeting a really big drilling program next year, and we were able to announce that in May now, so last month, yes, that the BLM had deemed our application for an exploration plan of operations complete, and that now triggers, basically an environmental assessment process, which, takes a while. The approvals process in the US is slow compared to, say, Western Australia. But there's a process we're following and we expect to have, everything approved by the middle of next year, and that will allow us to embark on a much bigger drilling program, conversion of indicated resource to measured and collection of a lot of, samples for bulk metallurgical test work. So, no, look, things are moving along very well, Andrew.
Things are moving along and still plenty of positive tailwinds as far as industry developments and sentiment for lithium.
Oh, yeah, no, there's been, in our announcement, we mentioned things like some of the money that's starting to flow towards lithium, US lithium projects from the Department of Energy under the Inflation Reduction Act. And also on the permitting side to try and compress the permitting timeframe. There's a bipartisan review going on, a committee reviewing the permitting process and looking to, you know, for critical minerals projects, it's essential that these mega projects like McDermitt are developed in a timely timeframe, so that, you know, that our lithium can feed into the battery factories currently being built, you know, across the United States. You've also seen the automakers moving further upstream. In late January, GM took a $650 million placement from in Lithium Americas, who own our a neighbouring project, the Thacker Pass project, which is now under development, and so that's another really positive sign that there's funding for these projects, not only coming from the Department of Energy loans, but also coming from off-takers who are looking very keen to secure lithium for their battery factories.
Good to catch up, Lindsay. Thanks for your time.
Yeah, thanks, Andrew. All the best. See you.